So, Mr. Avramopoulos, you've been here. There's this big forum on democracy. And one of the main issues challenging democracy is the inability to deal with the refugee crisis. What have you been telling all the people watching, including lots of government types?
Finally, it's not the economic crisis that is putting the European project at stake, but the refugee crisis.
Even more than the economic?
Even more than the economic. And I think that it is the moment all Europeans to decide to make a step forward and implement what we all together have decided in the field of relocation and resettlement. We persist on that. But let me tell you that the flows, fortunately, have subsided during the last 5 months, thanks to the implementation of the EU-Turkey deal that works.
So let's go into that, because everybody is, you know, wants to know, is it really working? Is it not working? Is Turkey playing the good guy, holding up its end of the bargain? You say that it has slowed for 5 months. It is working.
Yes.
So what exactly does that look like? What is Turkey doing?
Comparing it to what we are living here in Greece 1 year ago, where more than 10,000 people were crossing the Aegean Sea, doing this dangerous journey to come to Europe. Now, about 50 to 60 persons, which...
You mean per day, per week?
Per day.
Per day.
At that time. Now, about 50 people. So the situation is quite manageable. But still, there are 60,000 people in Greece. The reception capacities have improved, fortunately, thanks to the support of the European Union, financially, politically, with a lot of experts.
Mm-hmm. How but much the are they having pressure... to give the European Union? How much you know, are they doing
Greece,
to improve
Greece,
the conditions?
We have allocated for Greece approximately 1 billion euros so far. But the main pressure right now is on Italy, because the flows from Central Africa, the ones, the desperate people who come on the shores of Africa, they cross the sea, they arrive in Italy, and more than 120,000 people have died during the last 6 months.
Wow.
But the most of them, they are irregular migrants. From this side, from Greece, they are mainly refugees from Syria. So the situation is better, but we are not there yet. We have some shortcomings and some shortfalls. And just at the beginning, all member states must realize, must understand that this is the moment to deliver. Unfortunately, some governments do not show the spirit of solidarity and responsibility, as they should do. So we have extended strong messages. They must do it as soon as possible. If they don't do it...
Call them out. Who needs to be called out?
They need to be publicly shamed and named.
Because
I make a distinction between governments and states, because we all talk about member states, but there are governments. Unfortunately, some of their leaders, they follow the dangerous road for their democracies of populism and xenophobia.
Well,
and
the Eastern European countries, for instance, the new arrivals, the latest arrivals to the EU, have flatly said, we don't want these migrants.
Since you pushed me to tell something, these countries have lived the experience, have suffered the experience of refugees just 50 years ago. So they should be the first ones to tell us, do more for all these desperate people who take the journey, this dangerous journey to come to Europe to find a safe haven. And on the other hand, we must understand that we don't talk about numbers anymore. We talk about human beings.
Yeah.
I mean, and the public opinion has understood it. But it is the moment for Europe, and I'm not talking about the European institutions, but member states, to start delivering. And we are putting pressure on them, trying to tell them once again that responsibility and solidarity, they are not moral values, they are legal values explicitly stipulated in the treaties.
So you are standing with this amazing parliament, the Greek parliament, in the background
here.
I have
spent 10 years of my life there, before I became
So you know the difficulties of pushing this through on a government level. This government is cash-strapped. How much pain and suffering is it for the Greek government, the Greek state, to maintain even the 60,000?
In the beginning, Greece was caught by surprise. And it is true to say that for more than 9 months, they were not in a position to manage the situation, because they are not confronted with an enemy who was invading Europe. As we said before, they are human beings. And you know that according to the Geneva Convention, they had to respect what was decided at the time and provide them with support and help. But at that time, we had a problem in Europe, how to better manage our borders. Now we made a step forward 1 year after. As you know, we're about to fully operationalize the European Borders and Coast Guard, which will have as main mission to better manage the borders. Things have improved since then, and the Greek government and the Greek state, and most importantly, the Greek people, have shown a very high spirit of responsibility and solidarity towards those people.
So you said people are getting better. People realize that these refugees are not the enemy. But actually, people, isn't it people, as you said, of these countries are the biggest threat to Europe? Those who don't like the refugees, those who are empowering the populist, parties that are pushing forward.
And not only that, they amalgamate terrorists with refugees. Yeah. And we don't have, so far, one case where a terrorist or one of the perpetrators in Europe was a migrant or a refugee.
Them using the migrant route, that's for sure.
And we must not make this mistake because it is unfair and inhuman, I would say. On the other hand, yes, we have to do more in order to provide our citizens with more security. That's why we have enhanced the cooperation with the member states, which was not the case before.
But again, what are you going to do and how are you going to hold accountable? Obviously, it is improving. We see that perhaps they're all in Turkey because they haven't come to Europe in the same numbers as they did last year or the year before. But still, and we've talked about this, governments are not fairly sharing the burden and not fairly distributing as they promised they would do. So how do you hold them accountable? How do you make them do that?
Well, we are not there yet, but I can tell you that we have the means, we have the tools.
I mean, it's been a long time,
Commissioner. We have the legal weapons to convince them and impose. Let's hope that it will not be necessary. It's very important for all of them to understand that it is their responsibility and their duty to do it. On the other hand, we shouldn't forget, I think we discussed before, that 1 year ago, we altogether decided to adopt this mechanism, this scheme of relocation and resettlement. Now, I understand there are internal problems and pressure on behalf of populist forces that threaten their system from inside, but it is not an excuse for me.
But, all of this is all well and good, but you've got big border fences, for instance, the Balkan route has been shut down. Now, you've been talking about a Bulgaria route. How is that working? I know you're going to go there, but I mean, what is that? What's that meant to do?
Smugglers are very resourceful in idea. So from the moment they found the Balkans route closed, they started diverting flows. Mm-hmm. And of course, Bulgaria needs our help. And today we made the decision to allocate a lot of money and also to send people, experts there, Frontex agents, in order to provide the Bulgarian authorities with the necessary support to manage the situation there. But, we must not be surprised if we see flows arriving at other parts of Europe. For instance, just 3 months ago, I was in Finland. Can you imagine that? 1,000 people had arrived in St. Petersburg. They crossed the borders and they entered Finland, in Lapland. I mean, we must be well prepared. That's why we decided to adopt a common European asylum policy and, of course, the European Borders and Coast Guard that will be fully operationalized from next month.
And do you expect the Syria ceasefire to actually work and to stop this
Hopefully,
flow?
Because now you ask the more critical question. As long as this part of the world is on fire, unfortunately, we are going to be confronted with new flows in the future, because these desperate people will decide to flee persecution and all these problems there. And we must do our best, the international community, European Union, United Nations, in order to find a solution, not only there, but also to Libya.